in option, you have to pay the premium. Maybe in the market, the dollar rate has gone down. So you will buy from the market. You will not go into option, but the premium is gone. So whatever lower rate, you will be able to buy, but the option premium which you have paid is gone. Agar rate market mein bahut badh gayi hai, you will buy under option. So you will be able to buy at the rate which was decided earlier, but still the premium is gone. So in case of payment, the outflow will be buying cost plus the premium. In case of futures, whether the rate goes up or goes down, you have to suffer loss or gain in futures. But in option, if the rate moves in different direction, if it is moving in a better direction, you do lapse the option, you go in the market. But if the rate moves in opposite direction, you exercise the option, don't go into the market. So in option, you have the benefit, you have the chance to get the benefit of positive movement, which is not there in forward, money market, futures, internal hedging, anything, which is only there in option. But in option, you need to pay the premium. Premium ka paisa jarur lagega. So the cost of premium is so high many cases that it is not advisable to do hedging through option. Hum log option ke through hedging agar karenge, nuksan hota hai. Because premium ka paisa itna jor ka lag chuka hota hai ki wo jo hum log ko positive movement ka benefit milna chahiye, hame wo nahi chahiye. So it is good in theoretical term that option is one of the best technique. But practically, it is not logical. By paying so much premium, getting that benefit is not advisable. That is different part in option. Future mein margin money denge wapis milega, option mein premium wapis nahi milega. So in your outflow, premium cost is always there. Maybe your cost of buying dollar is less, but your premium cost is increasing your cost. Are you getting what I'm saying? For futures and option, we can use the language which Weber was saying, opposite direction. But for forward, money market, leading, lagging and all that, we cannot use the language opposite direction. So if we explain the hedging like opposite direction, it will be going in the wrong direction, the right up. If we talk of swap, swap matlab, I want to do a project in Australia. Vaibhav wants to do a project in India, but Vaibhav is an Australian citizen and I am an Indian citizen. Now if I will arrange funds in Australia, since I am new to Australia, the cost of funds will be high, interest rate and all that is high. But if I will arrange funds in Indian currency, the interest rate is very good. When Vaibhav is arranging funds in Australia, the rate is very good, better than me. But if Vaibhav wants to arrange funds in India, the cost is very high, interest rate is high. So me and Vaibhav enter into swap. What is that swap? I will borrow in India INR for Vaibhav, and Vaibhav will borrow dollar in Australia. क्या फायदा होगा? I am able to borrow INR at a better rate. I am borrowing and giving to Vaibhav. So whatever INR interest, Vaibhav will pay. Just that the interest rate is lower because I have borrowed. Similarly, Vaibhav will borrow Australian dollar in Australia. He will give to me. I need to pay the interest on Australian dollar. What is the benefit? I need to pay lower interest. When the repayment will arise, I have borrowed INR. Vaibhav will give me INR and the INR will be repaid. When the Australian dollar need to be repaid, I will give Australian dollar to Vaibhav. Australian dollar Vaibhav will repay. So I am borrowing for Vaibhav. Vaibhav is borrowing for me. And by that, we are both saving interest cost. We are doing this swap because of interest rate saving. My commitment is mine. His commitment is his. Just that we are borrowing for each other. So it is basically the benefit of interest cost. We say that suppose one Australian dollar is 40 INR. So I will borrow 40 lakh rupees for Vaibhav. Vaibhav will borrow 1 lakh Australian dollar for me. The borrowing amount is different, but the value of that 1 lakh Australian dollar is equal to 40 lakh INR is same. Now on 40 lakh, Vaibhav will pay the interest. 40 lakh, Vaibhav will pay. I will pay 1 lakh dollar pay interest. I will pay 1 lakh. That is called swap. The benefit of interest we are getting. For that reason, we are doing a foreign exchange swap. How can I pay Australian dollar when I'm investing in Australia? I will be getting inflow in Australian dollar. I will pay. Vaibhav is doing project in India. He will get inflow in INR. He will pay. So there is no tension. We both are doing this for getting interest rate benefit. That is called swap in foreign exchange rates. Are you getting? Always I am using in the example India. So it is easy to understand. But in the exams, generally the questions will not be on India. It will be different countries. So you need to be very perfect in your understanding. This whole thing, I teach in around 6 to 7 class of 2.5 hour each. Sara cheez batane mein mereko total mein foreign exchange risk, forecasting of foreign exchange rate, PPP, IRP, then different types of hedging techniques, doing problems on that, whatever questions of the student, I take around 20 hours class. Then the foreign exchange entire with the risk management covers, which we are doing in 1 hour. So you can understand that is not comparable with 20 hour class. 20 ghanta ka koi substitute nahi ho sakta hai. 20 ghanta ko 1 ghanta mein cover kar rahe. Are you getting? Jab koi mere saath seema mein P3 class karta hai, to main P3 mein total mein abhi tak 20 class karaya hoon. Aur 14 class mein maine foreign exchange aur interest rate hi padhaya hai. Nothing else. So 14 classes is that which we are studying in 2.5 hour. So there is no comparison of those 14 classes with this one class. But it is revision type. That is not revision. That is understanding each concept. But I think that if those 14 classes is not done, this revision will not help. That I understand, which is my understanding. Because aap dekhenge class mein aisa aisa question Manish wagara ne pucha hai, bahut high level. And Manish, Indranil are very very studious student. Even though they are working, Manish ka to working hour hai 14 hour, but still he study. Every time he asks questions, maja aata hai unko padhne mein. The current batch is very fantastic. Now we are saying interest rate risk. What is interest rate risk? If I have borrowings or investment in which I will be getting interest or I need to pay interest, then because of change in the interest rate, I will be directly affected. Because interest rate badhne se ghatne se mereko kam thi milega, jyada pay. I don't have borrowing or investment, to bhi interest rate risk hai. Because when the interest rate in the market goes up, suppose I have this tuition center. From this tuition center, I am going to earn in 25 years. Whatever I will earn in 25 years, if I will find out present value, with the interest rate which is there in the market, I will get the value of this property. Interest rate in the market has gone up because of the election. Government is risk averse. So government is increasing interest rate to control inflation. So if I will find out the present value of the cash flows, the value of my tuition center has gone down. So even though I don't have foreign interest rate payable receivable, but my assets value is affected because of changes in the interest rate. So we are saying that those who are borrowing or investment, they will be directly affected by the interest rate. Those who don't have, still they will be affected by interest rate changes. At the same time, agar main assets or liability ko bhool jaun, lekin mere competitor hai, un logo ka borrowing hai, or interest rate goes up, goes down, their gain is my loss, their loss is my gain. So it is just like foreign exchange risk. We need to explain interest rate risk. It is relevant for everybody. Not that those who have foreign interest borrowing or lending, even though you don't have borrowing or lending, but you are relevant with the interest rate risk. That is explanation, introduction of interest rate risk. Not that the opposite direction. Introduction of interest rate risk. Again, for hedging, for safeguard of this risk, internal method or external method. Internal method is what? Smoothing matching, or what I should say, there is name written pooling. Ab ye smoothing, matching or pooling kya hai? Smoothing ka matlab hota hai ki aap borrowing or lending ek hi tarah ka rate pe mat kariye. You are borrowing always in fixed rate or floating rate mix. थोड़ा बहुत बोरिंग फ्लोटिंग, थोड़ा बहुत फिक्स्ड, तो इंटरेस्ट रेट बढ़ने से गिरने से ज्यादा नुकसान नहीं होएगा. मैचिंग, अगर आपका सारा बोरिंग फ्लोटिंग रेट पे है तो इन्वेस्टमेंट भी फ्लोटिंग रेट पे करिए. बोरिंग फिक्स्ड रेट पे है, इन्वेस्टमेंट भी फिक्स्ड रेट पे करिए, तो अपने आप इंटरेस्ट रेट बढ़ने घटने से बराबर घाटा स्टॉप नहीं होगा. पूलिंग, अगर आपका बहुत जगह इन्वेस्टमेंट है, बहुत जगह बोरिंग है, उन सबको एक जगह ले आइए और नेट ऑफ सेट ऑफ करिए, तो आपको नेट में बोरिंग कमती करना पड़ेगा. But again, there is limitations relating to internal methods. External, we need to follow. Under external, there is FRA, there is IRG, there is futures, there is options, there is swap. ये सभी चीजें applicable है. FRA, forward rate agreement. Forward contract in foreign currency. Forward contract in foreign currency. FRA, forward contract in foreign currency. अभी हमने ऊपर किया कि हम लोग का डॉलर पेएबल या रिसीवेबल है, वी विल एंटर इनटू अ फॉरवर्ड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट टू बाय डॉलर और सेल डॉलर. रेट फिक्स्ड है, एग्जैक्टली क्या जाएगा आएगा पता है. सो विद द फॉरवर्ड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट व्हाट यू आर गेटिंग, इफ यू हैव अ आउटफ्लो एग्जैक्टली व्हाट विल बी द आउटफ्लो इन होम करेंसी, इफ यू हैव अ इनफ्लो एग्जैक्टली व्हाट विल बी द इनफ्लो. सिमिलरली एफआरए में भी, मेरे को अगर 2 महीना बाद बोरोइंग करना है, 6 महीना बाद बोरोइंग करना है, तो मैं चाहता हूं कि 6 महीना बाद at what rate I will be able to borrow, it should be fixed from now. मान लीजिए BJP government फिर से interest rate बढ़ाने वाला है, and I am going to borrow in January 2019. Today the borrowing rate is say 10%. I want that in January I should be able to borrow at 10%. मेरे को ये चाहिए, क्या करूँगा? I will buy FRA for a borrower. He need to buy FRA. FRA माने क्या हुआ? I am entering into a contract today that from January, say for 6 months, मेरे को जनवरी में 6 महीना के लिए बोरो करना है. मैं आज के दिन एक कॉन्ट्रैक्ट कर रहा हूं कि इन जनवरी आई विल बोरो एट द प्राइम लैंडिंग रेट विच इज देयर इन इंडिया और से प्राइम लैंडिंग रेट एट +2%. इन क्वेश्चंस इट विल बी गिवन लिबर +2% बिकॉज इन द इंटरनेशनल मार्केट लिबर इज द बेस रेट बट इन इंडिया बेस रेट इज प्राइम लैंडिंग रेट. सपोज आई एम यूजिंग द वर्ड लिबर. After 6 months, I will be borrowing at LIBOR plus 2%. But maan lijiye 6 mahina baad rate ho gaya LIBOR plus 3. 6 mahina baad rate ho gaya LIBOR plus 3%. So in FRA, I will get 1%. In FRA, I will not borrow. I will get 1% in FRA. And in January, I will borrow at LIBOR plus 3%. Ma January mein market rate pe borrow karunga LIBOR plus 3. लेकिन मेरे को एफआरए में फायदा हो गया 1% का तो अल्टीमेटली मेरा बोरोइंग कॉस्ट क्या होगा लिबर प्लस 2%. मान लीजिए जनवरी में इन बोरोइंग रेट हो गया लिबर प्लस 1%. सो आई विल बोरो इन जनवरी एट लिबर प्लस 1 बट इन एफआरए आई नीड टू पे 1%. सो माय कॉस्ट ऑफ बोरोइंग विल बी लिबर प्लस 2%. सो इफ द इंटरेस्ट रेट गोज अप आई विल गेन इन एफआरए. इफ द इंटरेस्ट रेट गोज डाउन आई विल लूज इन एफआरए. And whatever is the rate in January, I will borrow at that rate. So whatever is my borrowing rate actually, with that, whatever is the loss or gain in FRA will be adjusted. And my borrowing rate will remain LIBOR plus 2%. This is called FRA. Kya fayda hua? Jaise forward contract mein exactly kitna aayega jayega, waise hi interest rate borrowing pe kya hogi, mere ko aaj ke din hi pata hai. That is called FRA. यानी कि मेरे को रेट गिरने का फायदा नहीं होगा रेट बढ़ने का नुकसान नहीं होगा. लाइक इन फॉरवर्ड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट फॉरेन एक्सचेंज बढ़ने और गिरने से मेरे को नुकसान फायदा नहीं हो रहा है. सेम थिंग इज देयर. आर यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग? आर यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग? If I want to invest, I am afraid that the interest rate will go down. मेरे को जनवरी में इन्वेस्ट करना है, इंटरेस्ट रेट गिर सकती है, तो मैं FRA सेल करूंगा. तो अगर जनवरी में रेट गिर जाएगी, मेरे को FRA में फायदा होगा, और I will be able to invest at a lower rate. लेकिन जो FRA में फायदा होगा, the total interest rate on investment will be constant. और अगर जनवरी में रेट बढ़ जाएगी, I will be able to invest at a higher rate. But FRA में लॉस होगा तो अल्टीमेटली माई इन्वेस्टमेंट रेट विल रिमेन सेम. सो इफ यू डू FRA इन जनवरी एट वॉट रेट यू विल बी एबल टू इन्वेस्ट और बोरो इज फिक्स्ड टुडे. दैट इज द बेनिफिट ऑफ FRA. सो देयर इज नो टेंशन ऑफ चेंजेस इन द इंटरेस्ट रेट. योर इन्वेस्टमेंट एंड बोरोइंग रेट इज कॉन्स्टेंट. ये नहीं है कि हम लोग को नुकसान नहीं हो रहा है. अगर इन्वेस्टमेंट में रेट बढ़ रही है मेरे को बेसी नहीं मिल रहा है, रेट गिर रही है मेरे को वो मिल रहा है जो चाहिए, तो बढ़ने का तो फायदा नहीं मिल रहा है ना. बोरोइंग में रेट गिर रही है, आई एम नॉट एबल टू बोरो एट अ लोअर रेट, आई नीड टू बोरो एट द सेम रेट. बट अगर रेट बढ़ रही है तो मेरे को बेसी नहीं देना है. सेम केस इन द फॉरवर्ड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट कि अगर फॉरेन एक्सचेंज रेट गोइंग अप यू डोंट हैव टू बाई एट अ हायर रेट, बट इफ इट इज गोइंग डाउन यू नीड टू बाई एट द रेट विच यू डिसाइडेड. So forward rate agreement can be compared with the forward contract in the foreign exchange market. Are you both getting what I am saying? Should we proceed or any question in FRA? IRG called interest rate guarantee. Just like option. So what is option? Positive movement benefit we will be getting, but negative movement benefit we don't have to suffer, which is always the case of option. In IRG, we need to pay premium which is non-refundable. Story: I want to borrow in January. I am afraid that the interest rate will go up. I enter into an interest rate guarantee contract. What is the meaning of that? I enter into a contract that I will be able to borrow in January at LIBOR plus 2%, just like FRA. The rate in January is LIBOR plus 3. So under IRG, I will be getting 1%. I will borrow at LIBOR plus 3. My cost will be LIBOR plus 3 minus 1, LIBOR plus 2. But in January, the rate is LIBOR plus 1. So I will borrow at LIBOR plus 1. But in IRG, I don't have to pay. When the rate is lower, I will borrow from the market. Under IRG, I don't have to pay. So if the rate is LIBOR plus 3, I am getting 1%. But if the rate is LIBOR plus 1, I am not paying anything. So if the rate goes down, I will borrow at a lower rate. If the rate goes up, I will be able to borrow at LIBOR plus 2. But in both the cases, whatever premium I will pay for entering into IRG, that will be added in the cost. So in forward rate agreement, I was not getting the benefit of positive movement. In IRG, I am getting the benefit of positive movement, but I need to pay the premium which is non-refundable. And the cost of premium is many times very high. So it is not advisable to go for IRG. It is advisable to go for FRA. Are you getting what I'm saying? Both FRA and IRG are over the counter. So they are available for any amount. कोई लॉ नहीं है, कोई एक्सचेंज नहीं है, आपको दूसरे आदमी के साथ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट करना है और कॉन्ट्रैक्ट हो जाएगा. इन इंडियन मार्केट दीज आर नॉट सो फेमस. आई एम नॉट सेइंग दीज आर नॉट एप्लीकेबल, दीज आर नॉट सो फेमस, वेरी लेस. बट इन वर्ल्ड मार्केट, फाइनेंशियल मार्केट, यूएस, यूके, दीज आर राइस एंड ब्रेड, दाल भात. So we are not doing this study for Indian market. We are doing this study for international market. When we will be working in MNCs and all that, for that purpose. Futures. Interest rate futures are quoted as 100 minus interest rate. interest rate futures are quoted at 100 minus interest rate. Suppose I will say that presently the interest rate in the market is 7%. Suppose interest rate at present in the market is 7%. So futures price will be 100 minus 7, 93. Matlab interest rate futures quotation understanding is very essential. Interest rate futures is a future, I should say, standardized. That is, you cannot do according to your own. Fixed maturity with fixed amount on fixed amount in each contract. Standardized fixed maturity with fixed amount in each contract. Generally, the interest rate futures market is also having quarter maturity. March, June, September, December. It cannot have other maturities. In every futures, interest rate futures, there is an amount which is inherent in the contract. Maybe 25,000 pound. The contract size is fixed in different market. So when you enter into a futures contract, you cannot change the maturity. You cannot change the contract size. That you need to accept. Suppose I need to borrow in January $110,000, but the futures interest rate futures contract is for $25,000 per contract. So either I will enter into four contract, so it is 25,000 into 4, 1 lakh, 10,000 is not hedged, or I will enter into five contract, 25,000 into 5, 1 lakh 25, that is over hedging. But how the hedging will work? I am saying that the interest rate futures is quoted as 100 minus interest rate. So if the interest rate will go up, presently the interest rate is 7%. If the interest rate will go up, then the futures price will reduce. If the interest rate will be 8%, futures price will be 100 minus 8, 92. If the interest rate will increase, futures price will reduce. Suppose interest rate increases to 8%. So futures price will be 100 minus 8 equals to 92. That means if the interest rate will go up, I need to borrow at a higher rate. In January, if the interest rate will go up, I need to borrow at a higher rate. But to hedge that, I have gone into futures. Aur mere ko interest rate ke badhne se futures mein fayda uthana hai. By increase in the interest rate, I need to gain in futures. लेकिन इंटरेस्ट रेट बढ़ने से फ्यूचर्स का भाव गिर जाएगा, 93 से 92 हो जाएगा. सो इफ आई विल सेल एट 93 एंड आई विल बाय एट 92, देन आई विल गेन 1%. 93 में सेल करेंगे, 92 में बाय करेंगे, तो 1% का गेन होगा. सो इफ आई वॉन्ट टू हेज बिकॉज ऑफ इंक्रीज इन द इंटरेस्ट रेट, आई नीड टू सेल फ्यूचर्स. आई एम सेलिंग फ्यूचर्स एट 93. Later on, interest rate goes up. The futures value is 92. I am buying at 92. So 1% is a gain. So I will borrow at 8%, but 1% is the gain in futures. So my net borrowing will be 7%. But if the interest rate in the market is 5% in January, the futures price will be 95. So I sold at 93 and now I will buy at 95. So 2% is a loss. And I am borrowing at 5% from the market. The total cost is 5+2, 7% is still. So if the interest rate goes up, goes down, my borrowing cost will be 7%. If in interest rate going down, in futures I will lose. If the interest rate is going up, in futures I will gain. Ultimately, my net cost will be 7%, which is just like FRA. FRA is over the counter, not standardized. It is not over the counter standardized. But FRA and futures are giving you the same thing. If I am a borrower, I will sell futures so that if the interest rate goes up, I will borrow at higher rate, but I will gain in futures. And if interest rate goes down, I will borrow at lower rate, but I will lose in futures. So my cost of borrowing will not change. My cost of borrowing, but here again I need to pay margin, which I will get back for entering into futures in any market, commodity market, foreign exchange market, interest rate market, any market. You need to pay the margin money, which you will get back. Nuksan nahi hoga, lekin margin jana aur aana to hoga na, interest ka to loss hoga. But futures is just like FRA. Futures or FRA mein koi difference nahi hai. Future and FRA both are same. Are you understanding this concept of futures? Both of you. Any doubt, any question? So we are moving. Options. Option is option on futures rate. Matlab option ka bhi bhav wahi hai jo futures ka bhav hai. 100 minus interest rate. So we say that in case of interest rate, it is an option on interest rate futures. Option ka fayda kya hai? If the rate will move in opposite direction, you will gain. But if the rate is moving in positive direction, you will not lose. Humne abhi upar baat kiya ki interest rate 7 se 8% ho gaya. To hum log market mein higher rate pe buy karenge, futures mein fayda hoga. Same, hum log market mein higher rate pe buy karenge, option mein fayda hoga. But agar market mein interest rate gir gaya, so we will be able to buy at a lower rate, option mein nuksan nahi hoega. You don't have to pay. You will be able to buy at a lower rate in option. There is no loss, but premium gone. So cost of borrowing kya hoga? Whatever the rate of borrowing plus the premium. Option mein ek akela aisa hai jahan fayda hota hai, nuksan nahi hota hai. But premium dene ke padle. So if you pay the premium, then only you are getting the benefit of this. And generally the cost of premium is so high that people don't like option. When you will be doing this practically, then only you will be able to understand. Padhne ke time pe aise hai, but when you enter into practical market, you will find that option is not advantageous in most of the cases. For getting the benefit, upside benefit, not losing the loss, you are paying huge premium. That is not justified. Getting the benefit of positive movement but not losing on negative movement, but option premium is gone. ऑप्शन का प्रीमियम गया भाई, उसका कुछ नहीं कर सकती. सो इट इज जस्ट लाइक फ्यूचर्स, जस्ट दैट आपको नुकसान नहीं होगा, प्रीमियम देना पड़ेगा. इट इज जस्ट लाइक फ्यूचर्स बट प्रीमियम यू हैव टू पे. मार्जिन मनी नहीं है कि वापस मिल जाएगा, प्रीमियम का पैसा आपको देना पड़ेगा. सो देयर इज नो डिफरेंस बिटवीन ऑप्शन एंड फ्यूचर्स, बोथ आर सेम. ऑप्शन के अंदर आपको नुकसान नहीं होगा, प्रीमियम तो लगेगा. रेट बढ़ने से नुकसान नहीं होएगा, रेट गिरने से आप लोअर रेट पे बोरो कर पाएंगे, बट आपको ऑप्शन में नुकसान नहीं होएगा. स्वैप प्रकाश, वैभव, आई वॉन्ट टू बोरो, यू वॉन्ट टू बोरो, बोथ वॉन्ट टू बोरो. आई वॉन्ट टू बोरो एट floating rate. Why? Because I think that, okay, re-login. Wants to borrow fixed. मेरे को लगता है इंटरेस्ट रेट गिरने वाला है, तो आई वॉन्ट टू बोरो एट फ्लोटिंग रेट. वैभव को लगता है इंटरेस्ट रेट बढ़ने वाली है, तो ही वॉन्ट टू बोरो एट फिक्स्ड. इंटरेस्ट रेट गिरेगी तो आई नीड टू पे लोअर इंटरेस्ट, बट इंटरेस्ट रेट बढ़ेगी, फिक्स पे बोरो करने से बेसी नहीं देना. फ्लोटिंग रेट लिवर प्लस 2%. Here, LIBOR plus 5%. Fixed rate ₹8%. ₹9%. Now, I want to borrow floating, so my borrowing rate will be LIBOR plus 2. I want to borrow floating, my rate will be LIBOR plus 2. Whoever want to borrow fixed, rate will be 9. So combined interest rate will be LIBOR plus 2 plus 9, LIBOR plus 11%. But if I will borrow fixed, even though I don't want, I borrow fixed 8%. Whoever will borrow at floating, LIBOR plus 5, the total cost will be LIBOR plus 13%. The example which I have given, I should borrow floating on my own, Vaibhav should borrow fixed on his own, because the total cost will be LIBOR plus 11. But if I will change this, I am making this 12%. Now, if I will borrow floating, my interest rate will be LIBOR plus 2. Whoever will borrow fixed 12%, total will be LIBOR plus 14. But if I will borrow fixed 8%, whoever will borrow floating, LIBOR plus 5, total will be LIBOR plus 13. So if we borrow what we don't want, then the cost will be LIBOR plus 13. But if we borrow what we want, then the cost will be LIBOR plus 14. Why this is happening? Because the market is not so good. Otherwise, the difference in the floating rate is 3%. So difference in the fixed rate should also be 3%. But difference in the fixed rate is 4%. This you can say the market imperfection. We cannot question that. That is market imperfection. So to reduce interest rate, we both enter into a swap. Hum log dono ek swap mein ja rahe hain. I means Prakash is borrowing at fixed rate at 8%, even though he want floating borrowing. Vaibhav is borrowing floating at L plus 5%, even though he want fixed. So total cost of borrowing 8 plus L plus 5 equals to L plus 13%. But if they both would have borrowed according to their desire, cost would be LIBOR plus 2 plus 12, LIBOR plus 14%. So if they both are doing against their desire, cost is 1% less. It is LIBOR plus 13, it would have been LIBOR plus 14. This benefit is divided between both 50-50. So effective cost for Prakash, if he would have borrowed on his own floating, LIBOR plus 2 minus 0.5, 1% half minus 0.5, it should be L plus 1.5%. Effective cost for Vaibhav, 12 minus 0.5, 11.5. Why we both are entering into swap? This is the benefit. We want to reduce our cost of borrowing. For that reason, we are doing like that. Now, how to show the swap arrangement? How to show the swap arrangement? Prakash. Actually borrowed at 8%. What should be his cost? His cost should be L plus 1.5%. His cost should be L plus 1.5%. So he will get 8% from Vaibhav and he will pay L plus 1.5% to Vaibhav. प्रकाश ने 8% पे बोरो किया, वैभव से 8% ले लिया, खत्म, और वैभव को L plus 1.5% दे दिया, so प्रकाश का cost of borrowing L plus 1.5, वैभव का क्या हुआ? Actually borrowed at L plus 5%, उसने L plus 5 पे बोरो किया. इफेक्टिव कॉस्ट, वैभव को प्रकाश से क्या मिला और वैभव ने प्रकाश को क्या दिया? वी आर सेइंग दैट वैभव इज ऑलरेडी गिविंग एल प्लस 5% टू एट बोरोइंग वॉट एवर ही हैज बोरोड. नाउ he will get 8% from Prakash. 8% he is getting. And he is paying what? L plus 1.5. We have written that Prakash, his cost should be L plus 1.5. So he will get 8% from Vaibhav and he will pay to Vaibhav L plus 1.5. So for Vaibhav, Vaibhav has already borrowed at L plus 5% and he is paying to Prakash 8 and he is getting from Prakash how much? L plus 1.5. So what is the effective cost of Vaibhav? Minus L plus L gone. Minus 5, minus 8, minus 13. Minus 13 plus 1.5. Minus 13 plus 1.5, minus L plus L gone, minus 5, minus 8, minus 13 plus 1.5. So it is 11.5%. Minus means Vaibhav cost is 11.5%. What we said, by doing the swap, the cost of Vaibhav will be 0.5% less. Whatever I have made arrangement, this one, this can be anything, whatever we like. It is not necessarily 1.5 or this, but just for easy, we will set off 1%. The another will automatically come this. So what is the purpose of interest rate swap? Is still to reduce the interest cost. If they would not be entering into swap, the cost would have been L plus 2 and 12. But they enter into swap, the cost is L plus 1.5 and 11.5%. 0.5% cost for both of them. The benefit of swap is that the two parties will be able to reduce their interest rate when they enter into swap, which was the case in foreign exchange also. In foreign exchange also, ultimately, I discussed the reduction in the interest rate And in the interest rate swap, I'm actually discussing the reduction in the interest rate. So to reduce the interest rate, we enter into swap. How to arrange between each other what figures, that is upon us. But if we follow this procedure, which I am saying, it is easy to adjust so that you will get the net cost lower for both of them. That is called interest rate swap. So there is interest rate FRA, interest rate guarantee, futures option swap, other than internal hedging and in foreign exchange. These are the all techniques which is you can see not only in ACCA, in anywhere in the world, these are the techniques for hedging interest rate risk. Now every book is writing in a different way. The objective is to explain you everything in 1.5 hour, 2 hour. For that reason, maybe if you think that I'm in speed, but that we need to cover up in 1.5 hour, 2 hour. For that reason, I was slightly in speed to cover up the every concept relating to hedging. Now, even though if the question will be on numericals, if we understand the concept, then only we can write a flowing proper answer. If the concept is not there, even numericals, maybe we can do plus minus some wrong, but the theory will be entirely wrong. Because for writing and hedging answer, the understanding should be very good. Then only your language should be proper to explain the hedging process. And you cannot say that whatever is written in an answer or in a book, your language should be same. Your language will always be obviously different. But if you understand, you can write a proper, fantastic answer. Now you both will be saying, if there is any question for any term or in the book you want to ask, which you struggled, then I can help you in that area. Can we fix like that? Today is Thursday. You do a study on Friday till next day. And Saturday around this time, 3 to 4, 5, we can have a class. Can we do like that? Or maybe not in this area, in any other area, whatever doubts you both have. Along with the hedging, anywhere. We can again have a class at around 3 o'clock on Saturday. For 1.5 hour, 2 hour, whatever is required. So that whatever problem you both are facing anywhere, we can discuss. Okay. So we will be meeting again on Saturday at 3 o'clock. Okay.